the past 3 months, this country has put forth cautionary restrictions and attention to stop the spread of a deadly virus and to save lives. But within the last 30 days, three black lives, Breonna Taylor, Ahmaud Arbery, and George Floyd, have all been brought to prominence with the common thread of having their lives snuffed out and snatched by a plague even more vicious than COVID-19. This plague, unlike COVID-19, is not invisible. We're seeing it far too much, and it's time for every legislator, leader of a city, state department, government agency to put forth the same effort and urgency that has been put into the cure for COVID-19. My heart has become overwhelmed and burdened as a result of these tragic, senseless crises and killings. As such, first responders of the law enforcement community of the county must do better. We as black people deserve better. We are human beings created in the image and likeness of God. Just like all people, no one has the right to crush the very life out of us. Our black, brown, young men and women of color were not created to be executed in the streets by those who have taken an oath to protect life, or by anyone else for that matter. Our lives are worth protecting. I sorrow and I am praying for the families of these young men and this young woman who have suffered such great losses. I am praying now for the protection and safety of this generation of young men and young women that have been traumatized by so much. We must stand and fight, but not by looting, not by burning buildings, but stand together in love and in unity while we seek the Lord for strategic wisdom that will eradicate this awful blight of racism from among us and upon us. Dear Lord, have mercy on this nation, upon this world, upon all people of every color and of every creed. Dear Lord, bring this tendency to hate and to destroy away from us. Cover us with your love and with your truth. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.